and good morning, golfing world. It's Monday Morning Golf Wrap right here on TGD Today. I'm George Honeycutt, and with me, nobody. It is a solo act today for the Godfather, and I'm excited about it. So let's get started real quick. What's up with Ricky Fowler? He ends up winning the Abu Dhabi HSBC, and he does it in some interesting and really, really entertaining fashion. He makes double bogey on the seventh hole, turns around, then chips in for eagle on 8. Then on 17, as everybody's making a move for him, and I'm talking everybody with a pedigree. We're talking Rory McIlroy, world number 2, Henrik Stenson, and Jordan Spieth is trying to make some putts that he hadn't made in 4 days. Ricky finds himself in trouble again on the 17th. Lo and behold, he gets in that bunker, pops out, and chips it in again for birdie. Then finishes with a par on 18 to win by 1 over a charging group of horses. And what I mean by charging, Rory McIlroy looks like the entire day that he's number 474 without in the world rankings. And then all of a sudden, he birdies, he birdies, he birdies, he makes eagle. He moves 5 shots under par in the last 4 holes to close up the gap with Ricky Fowler, who at the time was just making the turn and really struggling. He wasn't really playing aggressive. He was playing conservative to the point that it was almost too conservative. So Roy comes in, then Stenson, who is just in front of Ricky, Stenson's all of a sudden making a move. He birdies 3 of the last 4 holes, and now he's right up there. And, of course, everybody's favorite, Jordan Spieth, number 1 in the world. He was several groups in front of Ricky, but he was finally making some putts. And it's interesting, during the post-tournament interviews with Jordan, he was the first one to admit, I hit it like a dog this week. I couldn't make a putt. I was either having problems with the speed or I was having problems with the line. And when you got problems on both sides of the house with a putt, folks, you're not going to make anything. And Jordan just looked out of sorts. And this really stems from, and he didn't come out, to Jordan's credit, he didn't come out with it, but I truly, truly believe that the pace of play penalty, if you want to call it that, a fine, actually, that he got on Thursday from the RNA and the rules officials there at Abu Dhabi, I believe that got in his head, and he pretty, from that point on, he couldn't have cared less whether he was there or not. So, interesting tournament, turned out great. Ricky Fowler, big win for him. It moves him, folks, get this now, he goes from number 8 to number 4 in the world golf rankings, with this win. So it's Jordan, Rory, Jason Day, and now Ricky Fowler becomes one of the big 4. So we go from big 3 to big 4. Now, Ricky likes where he sits. He's honing in his game, and he acknowledged yesterday in the post-tournament interview he is really looking forward to making a challenge at Augusta. He wants a green jacket. So, congratulations to Ricky for this big win for him, holding off basically several of the world top 10. And in doing so, he picks up a nice check. He picks up a good win. And now he can head back to the U.S. and start playing out in California where he really wants to be for the next several weeks. Also this weekend, of course, interesting tournament on the PGA Tour. And, of course, we're talking about the one that showed spotlighting Phil Mickelson in his return. And to Phil's credit, he plays extremely well. But he just got a little bit too far behind from the first couple of days, of course. Out there in Palm Springs, they are playing 4 different golf courses. They're flip-flopping around. Everybody plays one course a day, unless you're playing. You finish up on the stadium course, of course. But it's interesting in the fact in the CareerBuilder.com, which just signed a new agreement, they're going to carry this tournament into 2020+. But watching it come down the stretch, David Lingmerth, who's had one PGA Tour, just won last year, of course, but he won the Memorial, which was a huge event for him. And this is the guy that's going to pair up with Henrik Stenson and represent Sweden in the Olympics this year. So David is coming down the stretch, and we're sitting there watching him, and you're saying, my goodness, you know, Jason Duffner, who starts this day off with a decent lead in this event, but also, too, he's got the likes of Jamie Lovemark, who was chasing after his first win, several others who are either multiple-time winner or chasing after their first win, but several different flat bellies, as I call them, the new guys on tour, they were definitely moving up the charts and coming after Jason Duffner, who did not play all that well, but he didn't play all that bad. So Jason Duffner ends up in a playoff with David Lingmerth, and they finish tied for first, four shots clear of the second-place player. Jamie Lovemark, who was actually making a push for this thing up at the top of the leaderboard for a couple of days, Jamie ends up putting three in the water during his last round and still shot 73. So Jamie played extremely well, even though he seemed to want to do bass bombs all day long. But ends up Duffner, Lingmerth, playoff. They go back, play 18 again. They both make par, and frankly, Jason Duffner makes a par putt on 18. This after he drives it into a bunker right with a 3-wood. Now, he took a 3-wood to be careful and cautious and really to take the trouble out of play. Well, he blows it right, making sure he doesn't peel it into the water, and then he goes right into this bunker. He ends up using a wedge to get out. He lays up. He sends a chip in there of about 10 to 11 feet, and then he just steps up and drains this to tie Lingmerth. They go back to the tee box. They both hit. Now, Duffner, instead of hitting the 3-wood, he hits the driver the second time. They both end up in the quote-unquote rough on the right-hand side of the fairway. Lingmerth is hitting first. He's about 6 yards behind Jason Duffner. Now, you got water on the left of the green. It's a par four. Their approach shots, they're hitting anywhere from 7 to 8 irons. Lingmerth, knowing that Duffner is just in front of him, got the same lie that he's got the same conditions he's got. Evidently, he blames it on the rough catching the hosel and shutting the face down, but on his approach shot in the second playoff hole, Lingmerth ends up going into the water. Something you can't do, folks. You cannot do that. I mean, if there was any question at all that this thing could have caught the hosel with rough or whatever, he had tons of space on the right-hand side. He had tons of mounds over there. He had tons of grandstands over there. He had tons of spectators that he could have bounced something off of. But he ends up lining up. He hits a left-to-right fade normally. He lined up just inside the water hazard. And then he was planning on hitting a fade, which it caught the hosel, shut the face down a little bit, and it ends up going straight into the water. Well, Duffner from there, all he had to do was make par, and he ends up winning the CareerBuilder.com tournament here. So congratulations to Duffner. He needed the win. It's his fourth on the PGA Tour. So it was time for him to win, I guess. He's really trying to get his game back and his psychological game back to where it was just two or three years ago before he started going through the divorce and all the other things that's been happening to him of late. So, interesting tournament again. Another tournament that happened over the weekend here in the U.S., actually in Hawaii, the Champions Tour, the PGA Tour Champions, as the new title name is, the PGA Tour Champions playing at Hualalai. And we saw Duffy Wardolph, who is a character in itself with his clothing, his shirts, and the way that the kids used to paint his golf balls. Of course, the kids are now grown, and they're all in college or left home. So Duffy has to paint his own balls, I guess, right now. Can I say that on the air, Jeff? Thank you very much. So he ends up with Tom Lehman, and they come down the stretch. And actually, it was very entertaining, especially for us older guys, because we were sitting there watching Tom and Duffy both, interestingly, watching them select clubs and watching them play the wind and watching them play the fat part of the greens. And, folks, if you want to learn course management, And of course, we never, us as amateurs, we'll never know the amount of nerves and pressure and things of that sort that these guys feel when they're playing for on the Champions Tour $200,000 or $300,000 for first place. But we won't know that. But actually, we can learn from that in the fact of where we aim our shots or where we see our misses going. It's just like David Lingworth. How do you, in the rough, you're questioning the lie anyway, and you still aim over the water to hit your anticipated left or right shot? Again, I think I would be aiming front right green, and if it goes straight, then I'm on the front right of the green. If it actually goes left or right, then I'm up in the mounds and I chip down. Jason Duffner had not proved anything that he was going to birdie or eagle that hole from the same spot up in front of him. So, again, a rookie mistake. You don't want to call him a rookie because, I mean, he's one of the known players now on the European Tour. He's going to represent Sweden. But when Lehman and Duffy was coming in, you saw the amount of, let's say, elder knowledge when it came to managing their game. So it was fun watching them come down the stretch. It was fun watching them with Duffy and Tom and their match as they came down. Excuse me, folks. So, you know, it's we talk about it on the LPGA Tour about how you can watch these pros and learn things from them. And never was the truth more told than this weekend. Watching Ricky handle the nerves, basically winning by one, then watching Duffy and Tom come in and manage their aspects of their game. They both weren't hitting it great, but Duffy Wardoff ends up making a 25-footer for birdie on the last hole to win the tournament over Tom Lehman. And Tom was half that distance away and didn't end up making his. So, and Duffy took no time. Duffy just gets up and pounds it in. And Tom felt a little pressure, I think. He comes up about a half a ball short. Dead center of the cup, but comes up about a half a ball short. So Duffy ends up picking up the win in Hawaii. So a lot of fun over the weekend, a lot of entertainment over the weekend. This week actually is the Farmers Insurance Open at Torrey Pines. So the boys go back to one of our favorite golf courses. Of course, they'll be playing both the North and the South course. And we all want to see what happens on the South course. And this is, of course, old stomping ground for Phil Mickelson and the like. And we'll also see this week the return of Jason Day. So Jason Day gets his, quote-unquote, new calendar year started as far as his tournament play. So Jordan Spieth is headed off to Asia. He's got a nice little payout to show up over there in Malaysia. And then, of course, the European Tour is sticking around in Abu Dhabi, and they've got the Qatar Masters coming up this week. So a lot more golf coming up for you right here on Monday Morning Golf Wrap and later on in the week, of course, in many of our other shows as we talk about the world of golf. TGD Radio and TV are produced and broadcast by the Zeus Radio Network for thegolfdirector.com. All of our programming is archived for listening and viewing on demand. To catch up on any show you may have missed, you can click on the TGD Radio or the TGD TV tabs in the menu screen at thegolfdirector.com. We're now available on over 1 billion devices at iTunes, Audio Realm, TuneIn, YouTube, Ustream, Roku, Periscope, Catch.me, Blueberry, and, of course, the Myrtle Beach Golf app. I'm George Honeycutt for HR3 that's not here, for Al Cloyd that's not here. But who is here? Jeff Gilder behind the glass. We want to thank you for joining us on Monday Morning Golf Wrap right here on TGD Today. But don't go anywhere. There's a lot more golf news and information coming up next.